Hey everybody, this is Trina here at In Cosmetics in New York City. We're at the Javits Center right now, and I have this incredibly lovely guest, Dr. Claudia Aguirre, is here with us. And we are going to talk about how stress and the lack of sleep affect skin. So the big question, Claudia, is does stress, lack of sleep, and other like external factors really affect the skin?
Totally.
Okay, let's talk about that.
Probably much more than we've ever thought. So when it comes to psychological stress, there's like a full-on wired pathway that starts in the brain from maybe an argument you had with somebody or a car accident or even something less traumatic, you know,
right.
Like traffic, you know, getting somewhere. So
exactly,
that starts in the brain, triggers a series of hormonal reactions starting in your hippocampus and your amygdala all get involved. And then, you know, the hypothalamus releases hormones that then travel down through your body, releasing cortisol, releasing epinephrine and norepinephrine, of course.
Okay.
But these hormonal changes in the brain and body then result on inflammation in the body because you're getting kind of ready to, you know, go fight or flight. When you have this sort of fight or flight response, or even a long-term stress, which is the worst kind of stress,
mm-hmm.
chronic stress equals chronic inflammation. So what that means is that if you've got an inflammatory skin condition already existing, like acne.
I was going to say that would be an example is acne.
Or eczema or psoriasis, rosacea, these are all inflammatory skin conditions. So once you already have that as living in your skin, then of course you shoot it with more inflammation and it triggers a breakout. It triggers an eczema flare-up. It triggers a rosacea flare-up. So
right.
That's how stress immediately and over a long period of time can cause skin issues. The worst part is like when it's not managed, then it just compounds and compounds, and so you have this, you know, turns into like a full-on skin condition that needs to be managed from the inside and out.
That's really interesting. And this idea of wellness or skin health tied to our mental health or how we perceive things around us.
Yeah.
Now, is this relatively new?
This is kind of new. So
okay.
In terms of the brain-skin connection, I talk about this as a neuroscientist,
mm-hmm.
but this is ancient wisdom too. We've always kind of known, ancient traditions have shown us that the mind is connected to the body.
Right.
So there's always been this mind-body connection, but what we're seeing now is the neuroscience that shows and illustrates how it works.
And once we know it, then can we find better ways to manage it? Because I can't prevent stress from happening. I don't know about you.
Yeah.
But.
Well, here's the thing. You can prevent it from happening, but you can prevent how you react to it.
Ah, okay. So managing your stress. Got it.
Yeah, so that's the key, is how you react to the stressors.
Mm-hmm.
If you can manage that, if you can... There's a little bit of mindfulness that goes in on it. So basically, if you are aware of it and you have pay attention to it, you're able to then cognitively say, okay, here we go, I'm getting stressed again.
Right.
Let me block, you know, this from getting out of hand, and do a couple things that might immediately mitigate the stress response. That could be a few deep breaths.
Okay.
That could be taking a little bit of a walk and taking a break, taking a mental break. And then, of course, in a longer period of time, self-care is essential. You know, it could be, again, taking a breather or doing a meditation, a yoga session. So these are mind-body therapies that do work, and that they do have an effect on the brain and the body.
How does this relate, or does this relate to what you're talking about today?
A little bit. So I'm going off of a bit of a tangent here, and
okay.
It's neuroscience.
Yes.
But I'm talking about our perception of beauty. So from fillers to filters, we have really gone the gamut of how we alter our appearance. But now our appearance is altered much more digitally. And we're seeing things like artificial intelligence, augmented reality, anybody that uses those filters out there. So this is
guilty sometimes.
This is augmented reality, and this is impacting how we perceive ourselves and how we perceive beauty in general.
Right.
So my question is, what does that mean? What does it mean for our sense of beauty to be potentially manipulated by artificial intelligence and augmented reality?
Mm-hmm.
Are we ready for this? Do we know that our brain is constantly changing as we see things, as we perceive things? Our perception is a reality. Right. And our reality is changing.
Well, you are going to be speaking here at what time? Not too long from now?
Yeah, 3:45.
3:45.
Marketing Trends Theater.
You can catch her there. And if you have any questions, feel free to send them all over, and I'll try to get some answers for you, okay? All right, take care, you guys. Bye. Bye.